Hello everybody, in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to not get scammed in the Duel Arena, or at least what to look out for, so it'll help you prevent getting scammed. So on screen are just three pictures of different types of shields people normally use to do the shield scam. The strike bow is the most popular one. Recently, the armadillo buckler became one popular because they just pull out the whole set and some people just forget that there's a buckler. Now I'm going to show on screen of just me and my friend doing it, but this is basically what happens when you get scammed by a shield. For the armor scam, somebody typically tries to sneak in some kind of active piece. Normally it's legs or top because they'll start the fight with more HP. So you gotta be careful of that. And if you do get scammed by it and you're in the fight with them, you can actually hit zeros on them, which makes it even worse. For the overload scam, someone normally tries to sneak in an overload sip into the inventory, kind of like this. And in the rules, they'll tick it off so they can drink in the fight. And if you don't know what an overload does, it basically increases your accuracy and your damage. The overload scam you can beat is just they do have an advantage over you. They can hit harder and they have a higher defense than you because of the overload. So it's best not to get scammed by it, but if you do, you do have a chance of winning still. The next scam to look out for is the Disruption Shield and the Vengeance scam. Now, most popular is the Vengeance scam because Disruption Shield requires Livid Farm to unlock. So like this guy's inventory right here, he has a bunch of items in it, kind of like showing off his collection, and casually there's just his runes. So if you ever see items in an inventory kind of like this, just don't fight. 9 times out of 10 it's probably going to be some kind of scam. And I mean, even if you just cancel it, you know, you're not losing anything. And I did write it from the perspective of like how the scammer would do it, because I've only seen it happen to other people. So like the fight would start, they would use the disrupt shield. So if they got hit, it would be a 0. And then you would attack and you'd hit a 300. And then after that, you'd cast Vengeance. And say you're hit 100, you'd reflect 75 plus whatever you're hit on top. I've never heard of anybody ever beating this scam, so be careful of it. If you see items in the inventory, don't accept. For this scam, you want to look out for the Runic Staff, because what the staff can do is it could store runes inside of it. So most of the time people bring Vengeance in it, And I put two examples, like one person hid it in the corner, and another person bought a bunch of polypore staffs and hid it in the middle so you wouldn't notice it as much. So be careful of this, because you don't want to get scammed by it. This is one of the most popular scams in the Duel Arena, the Rune Pouch scam. Now, the Rune Pouch can hold runes just like the Runic Staff, so what's inside? It's Vengeance. So you want to be careful of it, and just recently you can now change the color of the Rune Pouch. So the one on the left was what it looked like before, and the one on the right is what's typically used in the Duel Arena now. So it's a bit harder to notice, so be careful of getting scammed by it. Another very popular scam in the Duel Arena is the Titan scam. Now you want to be careful of this, because in the rules they take off enabling summoning, and if you ever get in a fight with them, they already have a Titan, so you'll be getting hit by the Titan special and of them attacking with a polypore staff. Like, here's a quick example of like where people hid the Titans. So right here at the entrance, the steel Titans are there. But the scammers themselves, there's probably like this guy right here, the P500 or the P100. And at the altar right here, they blocked them onto the pillars themselves, so they don't have a Titan near him, kind of like this guy right here. Like, you can kind of tell that he's a scammer because it's just looking at him. But because the Titans are over here and there, you can't really tell, so you got to be careful of the rules. Okay guys, for this scam, it's the melee scam. Now basically what you gotta look out for is they tick off no magic and untick no melee. And this is why I like to have no vials in my inventory, just in case if it ever does happen, you can actually attack like this. I'm attacking Matt right about now, but I can't do anything, but he could just take off his staff and he'd start punching me. So that's why I don't like to carry vials in my inventory. I like to leave it empty or just carry spirit shards. This is a scam that doesn't happen too often, but you still want to be wary of it. And it's taking advantage of the GE value. So a little while back, the Steadiest Warhammer was worth 130 mil in the GE. But in actuality, like, it was only selling for 50 mil. But somebody bought the Steadiest Warhammers for 50 mil and they came to the Duel Arena and they were staking people for 130 mil and they were just putting that in there. So they were only risking 50 mil for 130 mil. And it didn't just happen with the Steadiest Warhammer, it also did happen with the Steadfast Scale, or the Steadfast Boots, I should say. Like, his GE value was like 30 mil, but in reality it was only worth like 10 mil. So be wary of item scams. For the next scam is the money scam. Now, you don't see it very often because it's pretty easy to see, but it does happen sometimes. Normally it's going to be 100 mil or more because the cash stack will look the same. So say I put in 100 mil like this, they would put in 100 mil and then they would flip some rules around. So then while you're focusing on the rules, they would have changed the cash stack from 100 mil to 10 mil. But the easiest way to not get scammed, guys, is do spam click use those favorites, make sure that they're wearing nothing and there's nothing sketchy in their inventory. So for this game, guys, you gotta be careful of the wand. Now, I do have it in my inventory because I'm gonna show you guys it, but here it is right here. You wanna be careful because they'll tick off the rules like that. So that's why you wanna always spam your favorites. And because I ticked off the shield, we both can't use polypore staffs anymore, but because I do have the wand and it has unlimited air runes in, I could just sit here and just cast away. Okay guys, so this is what you kind of want to do when you first enter the duel arena. You want to make sure that when you put on your polypore staff, you have the spell on, because a lot of people die without it activated. And you don't need to do this, I like to, but I like to right click this cog and then just set it to legacy. And if you don't know how to get out, you just press the gear sign, go to settings, under combat mode, just tick revolution. For inventory wise, spirit shards and money, it's good. Nobody should really cancel out because, you know, spirit shards is just like a currency. It'll always hold a value of 25 GP. Even though it says 24, you just go to the guy in Tavernly right over here. Let's see, where is Tavernly? You just go to this guy right here. And you could right click him, sell shards, and each one will be sold for 25 GP. So I'm going to do a duel real quick. Okay guys, so this is what you want to look out for once she accepts it. So you want to use your favorites. This is the rules that you always want to use. Right here. Make sure you copy it and then click save. You want to check their armor, only make sure they only have the polypore staff. And nothing in the inventory, only like shards and vials. Or not shards and vials, but shards, coins. If there's anything else, like if you know it's safe, then go for it. But if you're not sure, just cancel it. There's no harm in it. I lost this one, but I hope you guys enjoyed. Maybe you learned something. And stay safe staking. Oh my gosh, I won. Pid. And you're going to come to learn to hate and love Pit at the same time. So, happy staking. Hello everyone, Alan here. Thank you very much for watching the video. Leave a like if you liked the video, and subscribe for more videos. And with that, peace out, Girl Scouts.